What role does media play in presenting crime? The media is an excellent medium for sharing information and everything that's happening all around the world. The media includes social apps, news channels, newspapers, etc. They provide people with all the important information they need and can also be used for entertainment. What is crime? A crime is an action that is offensive to specific people or societies and is punishable by law. Anyone who is involved in such actions is to be punished as an example. The media usually shares all the stories about how the crime is committed. But mostly, it doesn't show how they caught the criminal and the punishments for what he did. If the media makes it more evident, then surely there will be some positive impact. Media and crime. The first question that captures the mind of our readers is how media influences such criminal activities. Have you ever seen a robbery and thought that if he had done it this way instead of that, then he could not have been caught? You know that's how a criminal mind is set. You know how to control those emotions, as you don't need to do such an offensive action. A few people might feel the necessity to commit that crime to get what he is craving in his heart. How does the media influence on crime perception? That's something we have been discussing from the start of the video. Let me tell you a psychological study that was performed on children. A few children were called inside a place and were given a doll, aka the Bobo doll. They advised the children to play with them, but some of them impulsively attacked the doll. Do you know why? Because they have seen adults are performing such actions on the media. It shows that the children learn from whatever they see, and it doesn't matter if that's right or wrong, they see it as a thing to be discovered. How does the media report crime? The media is always in a hustle to find the most threatening crime news that will create a bit of chaos in the reader's mind. They tend to see the stories that suit the public and leave out the crime that most likely should have been reported. Almost 30% of the news is about the crimes being done every day. It is the fourth largest category for the media and is greater than the actual crime committed in society. The media has to be more precise and careful about these details, as it can also make people frightened. The journalists divide the crime based on how unique the crime is, who the victim was, how they did the crime, etc. The more the crime sounds interesting, the more it is favored to be in the news, either good or bad. Strange crimes. The media tends to report a strange crime or is done unusually and will leave rape news that occurred somewhere the way it has always been. The media should be spreading ways to protect the people they are most likely afraid of after the report. Higher status personnel. The media might keep celebrities' stories or any other famous personality on top of a severe crime. It will draw more attention, and that's what media is all about. Drawing attention and providing the news people might be interested in. Drama and violence. The acts and actions that include some drama or excitement with serious sexual violence are stacked because these types of crime news draw the audience towards them. Their only purpose is to increase their viewership. Simplicity and unexpectedness. People tend to get interested in the news that shows a different angle of crime or its simplicity. It is not completely the media's fault, as they are only providing the type of news people are interested in. The good about media. While we discuss how media has been influencing people to commit a crime, there is also a positive factor. There are multiple cases where a person might be thinking about committing a crime. But, after seeing what might happen to them, they stopped. It is the way the crime is presented. If the media portrays a clear picture of what might happen if they go for such an action, it will probably help reduce the crime rate. A clearer picture means more awareness and less criminal mindset. Role of social media in crime. Social media has been a den for reporting crimes, and in my opinion, it has been a great way to dealing with the crimes that people don't talk about. They help in bringing the guilty people. The role of social media in the justice system is very important in this modern era. You can report a serious crime, and it will spread like fire, and within a few days or hours even, the person can be caught, and justice can be served. There are also certain drawbacks of social media. The criminals can track their victims and their possessions to completely know what they can do to get it. Everything we see has a positive and a negative impact, but we start using it for the right things. No criminal will be born. What can we do to eliminate the risks? The media has to take a step back and understand how they can portray the crimes that negatively impact them. The parents and the educators also need to ensure further no person is influenced to commit a crime they see on the media. Role of journalists. The journalists should be more responsible for reporting the crime so that people don't feel threatened by thinking of doing it may as well stop. They should not publish the news based on worth instead of how it can do better for society. The victim's privacy should be kept safe as that's a significant drawback media fails at doing. They should educate the journalists on what to report and what not, so keeping in mind the public's mental health. The more responsible the media, the less the crime will be. Role of educators. The children in school should be taught what is right and what is wrong. And if they do something that is considered harmful, then what can be the outcomes? It would be best if you educated those children on the positive use of social media. The educators should take a step further to ensure the students don't make a mistake in portraying things that may hurt someone and cause chaos. The positive use of media by the users is essential. Role of parents. The parents should keep a close eye on what their children are doing and watching. There is a pot of stuff on the media that will negatively affect your child's cognitive thinking. Make it clear to them the amount of media they are allowed to use. It would help if you also involved them in reading such crime reports and analyzing what they mean and its punishment. It would be best to teach your kids how to keep themselves and teach them how they should treat others. Conclusion. There are positive and negative features of everything that is around it. It all depends on how we interpret those details and implement them into our lives. If a child is taught certain things about perception from childhood, they will not get deviant at any point. The media is just a mode by which the crimes are reported, either good or bad. In the end, it's the viewer's choice on how they see it, either as a caution not to do it or as an idea as how they can do it differently. That's all from my side. Now it's time for you to choose and spread the word before any of these media tactics become too harmful for our society. For more information about what role does media play in presenting crime, visit our website at communitywatchpaper.org.